As human beings, when we walk by someone suffering, it robs us of our humanity a little bit.
We have a chronic shortage of housing at every level, and that is driving waves of displacement.
Rents have skyrocketed, they've tripled in a relatively short period of time. We're creating a permanent underclass in the United States.
It is a huge crisis that is destroying the social fabric.
Every solitary homeless person is an emergency situation, and the alarm bell should be ringing. Right now, we have about one shelter bed for every six homeless people. But really, if we want to solve this issue, we need housing.
If you said, can you find me 500 to 1,000 more hotel rooms, I can't find them anymore. There's not 1,000 more.
It takes a really long time to get permission to build housing. And a lot of the time, the answer is actually no.
We have to look at a way to drive more affordability by lowering the cost of producing housing.
The costs are so high and the local money so limited that you're simply not going anywhere and you're not making progress.
We owe it to the people to look beyond sort of the politics and ego and debate.
This is a moment where government cannot afford to not take some risks.
Something has to be done now. My name is Patrick Kennedy and I'm the owner of Panoramic Interests. And for the last 5 years, Panoramic has been focusing on creating housing for the homeless. Conventional residential construction is based on a technology that was introduced in 1833 and has not changed much in the intervening 186 years. Using innovation and creativity, we've come up with the MicroPAD. The MicroPAD is 8x20, 9-foot ceilings, and it's got a cooking area, a bathroom, a shower, bed, desk, armoire. We have bamboo floors, quartz stone countertops. If the city gave us a permit today, we could give them a 200-unit building in less than 12 months.
A lot of people just think San Francisco, we don't have the land. We do have the land.
What's special about the MicroPAD is it can operate on smaller sites that conventional developers won't use.
In Oakland, we're looking at tiny houses and micro units.
Bringing, you know, prefab units to parking lots, for example.
Using shipping containers and stacking them and creating construction that way.
And those kinds of solutions are really exciting because they can be manufactured quickly, it reduces costs, and you can put a much broader income span of people in those units.
We have a need to house teachers, nurses, first responders. All of our tenants would be thrilled to move from where they are now into a MicroPAD.
I think it would increase my quality of life. I really do, because to transition to having a kitchen in my own bathroom, I would die for that. I really would. I would die for that.
Samuel Johnson said, the best measure of civilization is a decent provision for the poor and the underprivileged. And I think San Francisco, that fancies itself as one of the most civilized places in the world, can do this for its residents.
When I stood at the door, I said, I felt like a Dorothy who had just come out of this very old shack in Wichita and opened a door and looked into Oz.
A micro unit might be the difference between sleeping on the street or having a roof over their head.
Stove, sink, outlets.
Bathrooms.
Refrigerator, the bed. Yeah, shower. Those are things we're chasing every day.
If we're really being honest, and people are not often honest about homelessness, either we do MicroPADs or we're not really making a dent. That's the bottom line.
Yeah, that's the biggest problem. Not having a place to lay your head every night, having to worry about where you're going to sleep. Can't get much done. You get stuck in the cycle.
It's not just a sterile policy. It is a human dignity.
So maybe I can pass from this world with, excuse me, the way I came in, with dignity and respect. And that's why I see in the MicroPADs.